Good morning, everyone. We're ready to start our science demonstration, and it's entitled, May I Introduce You? And I want to introduce you to the straw family. Here's one straw. Here's another straw in the family of straws. And I had some other bent ones. They got misplaced, I guess. But our straw family is full of straws that are instead of them being straight like they should be, they're kind of crooked. Not only the straw family do I want to introduce you to, but I want to introduce you to the potato family. I have lots of potatoes here, and I wish you were here, Benjamin, to help me because I was planning on your help. But Ashley's here, and so we have the potato family, and we have the straw family, and we're going to open up that particular slideshow. It's very simple. You probably know all about this science demonstration. It's all over the place on the internet. There's not always accurate information about it, but what you need, the only thing you need is a potato and a straw, a nice straight straw, not one of the bent straws from the straw family. Now, I'm going to introduce you to some of the members of the straw family. So if you'll go to the next slide. The cast of characters in the straw family are like this. How can we ever know? I've been there, done it. It's so hard to tell. It's this way or that way. I'm worried, weary. Straight arrow. On the other hand, it could be this, it could be that. Doesn't matter. That's the straw family. Now, the potato family, members of the potato family are cheating helps. Oh, you're doomed. Ha 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 ha. That's pretty stupid. Once doesn't matter. I'm telling. The easy way. Those are members of the potato family. Now, remember, we had the straw family that says, doesn't matter this way or that way. And then we have the potato family that even says, cheating can help. Now, in this experiment, all you need are straws and potatoes. Now, I want, in your mind, I would like for you to imagine a big barrier built with blocks of potatoes. And these are like Satan and the things he tells us once doesn't matter. Or cheating can help. It all depends on the circumstances. And so all of these lies he tells us are built up into a wall of potatoes. Now, I have over here a paper towel roll. What shape is this, Ashley? Do you know?
Cylinder.
A cylinder. And here is a smaller cylinder, a toilet paper roll. Now, did you know that cylinders are one of the strongest shapes there are? If it's standing up straight like this, it's pretty hard to crush. I want you to try, though, Ashley. And I'm going to have her try to crush, and I'll turn my thing around so she can see. See if you can crush going down on the small one first. Keep going. Oh, okay. She flipped it by mistake, flipped over. And we're going to try again. But now, before she tries to do it this way, what if I asked her to squish this side? Would that be easy?
Yes.
It would be easy. But before you do that, try again to crush our cylinder. Cylinders are strong. Now lay it on its side and see how easy it might see. So the strength of the cylinder is when it's upright. And here's one that, no, if Benjamin were here, I would ask him to try perhaps. It's another cylinder, but it has a cylinder from supplies at the office, and it is almost as strong as a rock. Would you like to try? You can't crush this one. Even laying on its side, I don't think you can crush it. But Pastor's going to try. Let's see if we can see him. No, what about on its side? Can you crush? No. Let's see, I'm trying to get
No,
them. No.
it
So
can't be crushed.
cylinders are pretty strong. Now, Pastor, can you tell us what other geometric figure is very strong?
Triangles.
Triangles. Do you think triangles are stronger than cylinders? Yes. And so that's why roofs are made with structures that are triangles. But we have pillars that are cylinder that hold things up. Now, if we took this straw, Ashley, you want to come over here? If we took a straw, do you think, and those of you at home, if you have a potato, happen to have a potato, and some straws in your kitchen, now this straw has a wiggle part. So do you think, with it shaped this way, that you could get this to go through?
All the way through.
Yeah. Remember, these are Satan's lies that he tells us. It doesn't
Can
matter.
try.
Okay, she's going to try for us. Now, I'll have to tell you one thing. If you're trying at home, you don't hold it in your hand like this, because there is a way to get it through, and it could also go through to your hand. So you hold it to the side and go through this spot that doesn't have a hand. And you have to sh no, you have to hold it. You can't brace it to sorry, my dear. She's trying to screw it in. She's trying to push it in.
It's as far as it wants to go.
Okay, she got it in, and before it bent, she got it in maybe how far? Pull it
That.
out. An inch. Okay, by forcing it in. Now, I'm going to get a pair of scissors. I'm going to take another straw and cut off that wiggle part. You need a straight straw that doesn't have any of that bendableness to it. And so what we have now is just a straight straw. It's a plastic straw. It's not that strong. But I have two cameras to work with. Sorry. I'm going to go through Satan's lies with something. What do you think this might be? And go all the way through. We're going to try again. But it went through 2 inches, maybe, with a plug of potato in it. Let's give it another try. And Ashley, you can keep trying here. Oh, that's a bad one. I'm sorry. You want to try again? We'll cut off this. You can take your own potato and just shove. You got to use energy.
It's easy if you can do it this way.
Okay. If it didn't work one time, you try another time, because it should go all the way through. And I'll show you my there. I got one all the way through. See? See?
I don't see how you're doing that.
Okay, so Ashley's going to keep trying. Here's a potato I used yesterday, and if Benjamin were here, he could see all the way through. Can you see? When you pull out,
Yeah, I can see
yeah,
it.
it went all the way through. Oh, well, let's see if I find it right here, this one right here. Can you see through it? Down a little more. Okay, very good. Are we done? Okay, so now these straws, this straight arrow straw is God's word. And the lesson we're going to learn is God's word is sharp. It can pierce asunder the lies and delusions that Satan tries to fill our mind with. And here's one that went through. And I'm going to try to put another one through. Now, there, with one strike, it went through. And some people say if you cover up the top with your thumb, it will go through easier, and it might. And they say, even scientists, quasi-scientists, say that it's because the air pressure is built up in there and gives it more strength. But physics.org does not agree. They say that's a misconception. It's not the air that's pushing it through, it's the force and the strength of the shape. that goes through. The cylinder is very strong, and using force behind it makes it go through. Ashley's going to try again. But what I want you to remember from this little science demonstration is God's word is sharp. It will help us to be able to discern truth from error, but it must stand up straight. It can't be bent this way or that way and become part of the straw family that says, well, it really doesn't matter. It depends on the circumstances. What is truth? You see, it's this way. It's whatever way you feel convinced about, perhaps. No, you have to depend right on God's word. Stand straight and faithfully for him, and it won't matter how much Satan tries to build a wall of deception around you. With God's word, you can pierce right through it. You can see through his. And be careful, don't put your hand behind it.
I can't get it to go all the way through.
Okay, I'm going to help Ashley. Just wait just a minute here. We need to cut off the bendable part and take a smaller, but that's pretty small, and hold it here. And then what you're doing, say that helps. No. Try again. Okay, that one's already, try it from this side now. No. You're giving up. You know why? As soon as you get there, you pull back. You can't do that. You got to, go right in. Now, we'll give you one more time. See, what Ashley's doing is she pulls back and goes, and as soon as she hits it, she pulls back. Now, so we'll pull that out and just pretend like it's air and you're going right through it. Go! We're going to keep trying this because it will work. Okay.
It doesn't work for me.
All right. Now we want to move on to the next part of our Sabbath school. But thank you for joining us for our little science demonstration about God's word is stronger than anything Satan can put in your mind or tell you through other people or whatever. Thank you and bye for now.